Welcome into the Cam Rogers Show. We are presented by BetDSI, the number one online sports book. Get started today at chatsports.com/bet. BetDSI has given me a special bonus promo, so DM me if you want free money to gamble with this fall, ladies and gentlemen. Hit me up at MrRogers99 on Twitter. Fun show on tap for you guys for the next hour. NBA trade and free agency rumors, Lakers rumors, LeBron James rumors, and the latest buzz out of training camp across the National Football League. So let's get into it with the latest NBA trade and free agency rumors. We're talking about the Houston Rockets re-signing Clint Capela on a five-year, $90 million extension. There wasn't really any question about Capela returning to the Rockets. It was a matter of financials. And at one point, both sides were actually pretty far apart. There were some negative headlines out there about Clint Capela re-signing with the Rockets, but overall, there wasn't much doubt. Now, Capela was a restricted free agent. If he had signed the $4.3 million qualifying offer, he would have entered 2019 as an unrestricted free agent, something the Houston Rockets obviously did not want from their star scorer last year, kind of an under-the-radar player for the Houston Rockets a year ago. Of course, you think of the Rockets, you think of James Harden and Chris Paul, and very soon Carmelo Anthony as well. But Capela's coming off a career season last year, averaging 13.9 points, 10.8 rebounds, and 1.9 blocks. The Rockets were 42-3 last season with Chris Paul, James Harden, and Capela in the rotation, a core that led, of course, the Western Conference's best regular season record. So you got Chris Paul agreeing to a four-year, $160 million max deal earlier in July. Then you have Harden, who was inked to a four-year, $228 million supermax from last summer. And then the Capela contract pushes the Rockets' payroll to $136 million, the fourth highest in the NBA behind only Oklahoma City, which is now without Carmelo Anthony, Golden State, and the Toronto Raptors. So big-time re-signing there for the Houston Rockets. Speaking of Oklahoma City, PG-13, Paul George recently talked about staying with the Thunder. And in a way, he kind of stunned the free agency world by returning to Oklahoma City. And he recently gave some insight in terms of making that decision. Now, George said he privately decided to return to the Thunder several weeks before free agency began on July 1st. He also acknowledged that he thought LeBron James would join the Los Angeles Lakers regardless. So he wasn't really thinking about LA too much. Now, he did say, quote, "I just wanted my free agency to be over with. In my heart, I felt great about Oklahoma, and I wasn't going to prolong it if I felt good about it already," which makes a lot of sense here. Now, in addition, George said the Thunder's first round exit in the playoffs didn't actually deter him from returning, actually fueled him to come back and remain with Westbrook there. And went on to say, quote, "I just felt I had more to offer. I had more to give. I just felt about where we were as a whole." Now, George will be teaming up again with Westbrook, as I mentioned, hoping to take down that new powerful trifecta in the Western Conference, the Golden State Warriors, the Houston Rockets, and now you would think the Los Angeles Lakers. And with that, BetDSI has the latest odds for the 2019 NBA Finals champion, 2018-2019 season, of course. The Golden State Warriors are the favorites at minus 200. Then you got LA at plus 450, Boston at plus 450, the Houston Rockets check in at plus 800, and then the 76ers at plus 900. Chatsports.com/bet. What am I throwing down on that board? I like the Rockets a lot there in terms of value at plus 800. Re-signing Clint Capela, that is huge. Bringing in Mr. Carmelo Anthony as well. Hopefully he can mesh well with Mike D'Antoni and not have shades of the New York Knicks back in 2011 and 2012. So on that board, I'm throwing my money down on the Houston Rockets. Love that number at plus 800. And at some point, the Golden State Warriors are going to take a step back. Regression to the mean will happen. So who's next in line? You would think Houston. Some other names here. We got the Thunder at plus 5,000. The Raptors are there tied with the Thunder as well. Spurs, Utah Jazz, Portland Trailblazers. What sticks out here? Why not throw a little change on the Toronto Raptors? Maybe, just maybe, Kawhi Leonard and Kyle Lowry and Nick Nurse and the process that they have going on there works out this season, and the Raptors, again, get that number one seed in the Eastern Conference. They make a big-time run in the NBA playoffs because guess what? LeBron James is no longer in the Eastern Conference, so the Raptors kind of have that to look forward to as well. All right, folks, think you know more than NBA fans out there. It's time to be a player, not a talker. Get paid for being a genius when it comes to sports. Visit chatsports.com/bet. That's chatsports.com/bet. Go there. Use my exclusive offer to get up to $600 worth of free deposits. 120%, might I add. Use promo code CAM120. It's not gambling when you know you're going to win, right? So go there, start winning. Time to get paid straight up cash. Chatsports.com/bet. All right, let's continue along here in the latest NBA rumors. Mr. DeMar DeRozan apparently will not be speaking with the Raptors president anytime soon. So DeMar DeRozan recently spoke on the unexpected exit, if you will, from north of the border. And he hasn't talked to Ujiri since the Raptors president called him from Africa to break the news last week and says he doesn't intend to again. Now DeRozan said, quote, done. No reason to have a relationship. I'm done. Said it twice. It's just done for me from my end. It's hard to imagine this lasts forever, by the way, because perhaps DeRozan is still feeling the immediate after effects of that trade. And again, it was not a pretty situation, not a good look from a PR perspective for the Toronto Raptors, a franchise that promised DeMar DeRozan they won't trade him. And what do? They trade him in an effort to get Kawhi Leonard. So in that vein, yeah, I understand the frustrations from DeMar, but I think DeMar in these stages of, shall we say, unexpectedness or however you want to say it, is in the Dez Bryant phase, if you will. He wants the revenge. He's angry. He's salty. He's all of this. So was Isaiah Thomas with the Boston Celtics. And so, and even he, by the way, Isaiah, was willing to return to the Boston Celtics even after what happened there with Danny Ainge. So people get over things. I'm thinking that DeMar DeRozan will fall into that camp, but we shall see. Speaking of the Raptors here, do they want to sign a former Celtic? Greg Monroe. Toronto is reportedly interested in the free agent forward, according to a report from TSN. Now, Monroe would provide the Raptors with additional scoring power off the bench. Certainly wouldn't hurt in that regard. He began last season with the Bucks before he was traded to the Suns in early November. A bit of a journeyman here. He was waived by Phoenix after 20 games. He then signed with the Boston Celtics in February. Would be interested to see in the comments section from Harris what he thought about Monroe. Went on to average 10.2 points, 6.3 rebounds in 26 games for Boston. So he was a viable player coming off the bench there. Monroe, of course, high pedigree too. Former 7th overall pick in the 2010 NBA draft. So very much could be a part of the Toronto Raptors sometime soon. All right, once again, thanks to BetDSI for allowing me to bring you this fine program. Support them at chatsports.com/bet. The best promo code ever, folks. CAM120. It is easy to remember. That's how you get 120% worth of a deposit bonus. Free money, ladies and gentlemen. Cash out big time. chatsports.com/bet. All right. Are Rockets players out there excited for Mr. Carmelo Anthony to head on over to the Lone Star State? So the Hawks are expected to engage in that $27.9 million buyout with Carmelo. And then Melo is expected to join the Houston Rockets. And the Rockets players are reportedly ready. One report is that players are, quote, very positive about Melo joining. The excitement built up further, you would think, after the Clint Capela re-signing. So maybe there's some positivity fueling within the Houston Rockets locker room, while some negativity is arising within the Warriors locker room, as reported exclusively here on Chat Sports by Harris Rubenstein. Maybe the tide is turning a little bit in the NBA, at least in the Western Conference. You can say that for sure with the Lakers rising up the power rankings in many people's eyes. And the Houston Rockets now equipped again with Clint Capella and soon Carmelo Anthony. And the Golden State Warriors have to fend off complacency. And we've been saying that many times after the Warriors won an NBA title. But I think at this point, as Colin Coward put it, the Golden State Warriors could be at that brink where fractures begin to really show on the hardwood there. But in terms of Carmelo Anthony, my questions are these. Can he learn isolation touches on his own? Will he space the floor effectively for James Harden and Chris Paul? And will he want to, by the way? And how will Melo mesh with Mike D'Antoni? Can't be a repeat of those Knicks days back in a few years ago. So keep that in mind. Some questions there about Carmelo, but I am confident that he will be good for the Houston Rockets once he arrives there. Meanwhile, with Kawhi, did the Boston Celtics have a big-time draft package offer for the San Antonio Spurs? So the Boston Celtics weren't willing to deal any of their big-name players, but reportedly had a pick-heavy offer on the table for San Antonio. So ESPN's Zach Lowe said last week that the Spurs weren't all that enthused with the offer, obviously. But here's what the Celtics own in terms of draft picks. Sacramento's 2019 first pick, protected for number one. LA Clippers' 2019 first pick, first round that is. And then Memphis's 2019 first round pick. If the Spurs wanted to go the rebuild route, they probably should have done that deal. But obviously San Antonio thinks it can compete. So that's why they got DeMar DeRozan, to team up with LaMarcus Aldridge, and maybe the San Antonio Spurs can make the playoffs yet again because they are on a very consistent streak as we stand. But I think in hindsight, which by the way is 2020 as they say, probably would have been better for the Spurs to do that pick-heavy deal rather than trading away a Kawhi Leonard and getting a DeMar DeRozan who's a little frustrated right now on the roster at this point. But I am not in the front office. I am here on air with you. All right, let's continue along here talking about Kawhi Leonard. He and Nick Nurse, the head coach of the Raptors, recently met. And the conversation reportedly couldn't have gone any better. So here's what Nurse said, quote, "Not what I was expecting. Very smart, very intelligent, very engaging. Really enjoyed it. Management had to drag us out of there in the end because they had to go do something else. But it was great." Which is best case scenario if you are A, Raptors fan, B, a Raptors player, and C, Raptors front office. Because I would think there was a bit of an uncertainty element in terms of how Kawhi Leonard would respond to being traded to Toronto, a team we did not expect until, what, the final days? When Brian Windhorst said that the Raptors were in the driver's seat to get Kawhi? So hearing this news, hearing this report, it's the best possible outcome that could have happened for Nurse and the Raptors especially. Kawhi was engaging, sounds ready to work, and that should be his mindset anyway, right? If you're Kawhi Leonard, why pout your way through the 2018-2019 season? This is not a good look from a professional standpoint. It's not going to make you happy when you go home after work playing in basketball and making millions of dollars. You know, it's just not the way to go about it. So Kawhi Leonard obviously trying to make the most out of the situation. And you're talking about a team, by the way, that Kawhi is playing on that just got the number one seed in the Eastern Conference. And oh, by the way, had the NBA Coach of the Year in Dwayne Casey. So it's not like Kawhi is sitting out there in Sacramento trying to make the best out of playing with the Kings. No, we're talking about a team that was a force in the regular season. Key phrase, regular season, but still. Kawhi, making the best out of the situation, it seems. It's a good way to go about it. All right, Hassan Whiteside has been at the center of many trade rumors of late, but Heat president Pat Riley put all of that to bed. Recently went on record to address some of the swirling Heat-related rumors. course, Whiteside included here. Now, Riley said that the team has no interest in making Whiteside available via a trade, but also added that he, quote, has a lot of work to do. Maybe that work involves, you know, being a modern-day NBA center, because Hassan Whiteside is of the 1990s mold, if you will, among NBA centers, and he's going to have to adapt. He's going to have to change his game a little bit. He needs to improve his scoring. He can't just be a rim protector, and he can't just be a rebounder, and he can't just get his points from around the rim. That's just not how the NBA works anymore. So Riley also went on to talk about Dwayne Wade. She said that, quote, I want him back as a competitor. I want him back as a guy who wants to have the greatest year he ever had as a player. Now, there are only two realistic options for Dwayne Wade in terms of a contract, and it's not really a lot of money here. Now, he could either get $5.3 million via an exemption or $2.4 million via the veteran minimum. All right, so Wade can make that much with the Miami Heat, or he can make a gajillion dollars playing in China. So it's actually one of the more intriguing storylines at this point in the NBA free agency period, or however you want to put it, because Dwayne Wade might actually play in China just to cash out all that money. Now, again, I said this many times on my show that, he's still mulling whether or not he wants to play in the NBA yet again. Fact-checking myself, by the way. I think I accidentally said she for Pat Riley. He, Pat Riley, president of the Miami Heat. All right, you guys are watching The Cam Rogers Show. Get started with our partner, BetDSI. The website and promo code for free bonus money to wager on sports is the following. Chatsports.com/bet. The promo code CAM120 for 120% deposit bonus. CAM120 is that promo code. Use it today. All right, next up on the list here, could Kevin Durant be leaving the Golden State Warriors next season? Well, Colin Cowherd certainly believes that. Now, he said Durant will head to a new team in 2019 because KD is accustomed to change. Plus, it'd give Durant an opportunity to join the Lakers and, of course, buddy LeBron James. Now, Cowherd said that the Warriors dynasty is, quote, really close to the end. I kind of hinted at that earlier in the show. And that, quote, phrase and fatigue might take over as the team's core breaks up. I think Colin Cowherd read the exclusive reporting from Harris Rubenstein to come to that conclusion. That's just me, though. And NBA free agency 2019 is setting up to be pretty exciting. Of course, it's hard to compete with the LeBron James decision 3.0, but look at these names. Pretty good names on the board there. Kevin Durant going to be a free agent. Kawhi Leonard as well. Kyrie Irving and the Boston Celtics. Kemba Walker. Jimmy Butler, too. The most likely player, in my eyes, to change teams. Jimmy Butler. There's some buzz out there that maybe he might actually get traded before the deadline. So keep that in mind there. Kemba Walker wants to be with the Hornets long term. Kyrie ain't going anywhere, in my eyes. Kawhi, very intriguing name. I think he is the second most likely to change a team. And then Kevin Durant, of course. We'll see if that theory posed by Colin Cowherd comes to fruition. Will KD leave the Warriors in 2019? Type Y for yes, type N if not. And hit me up in comments. I want to hear from you guys here on the Cam Rogers Show, presented by BetDSI. Remember, get that 120% deposit bonus using that promo code CAM120.